Welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek 25th Anniversary. I'm the RPG Chick. I've made some changes. I have installed a Roland MT32 emulator called Munt. So now we're playing with better music, for one. Graphics may or may not be a bit improved. Not sure. Aspect ratio may differ. Not sure. But yeah, I've improved the sample quality, and now we're running not, you know, basic PC MIDI, but Roland MT32, and, well, I'm just going to play the intro again and let you guys hear the difference.
Space, the final frontier.
Hear
it. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its mission...
So much better.
To explore strange new worlds, to discover new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
Here we go. Check that out. Now compare that with the intro in the, you know, my first episode. I mean, we have the bongos here and everything. Pretty cool. Yay! Brian Fargo, executive producer. So, let's get back to the task at hand.
Demon World.
We're still playing Demon World.
Though the Enterprise is...
Captain Pat...
The Republic is on the way.
Load. This one. Okay, we're about to go in here. So, it seemed like a good place to stop off. All the way in? Why won't he go in? Hold on a second, let me look at this.
This looks like some of the hand security panels on the Enterprise. A long tunnel descends into the mountain.
We can't actually go down this tunnel? Oh, here we go. Hello? Sounds like Darth Vader's would be in here. I do not want to advance past the screen yet. Kind of looks like we're in Tron as well.
Many alien machines fill the room.
Well, these don't look that alien.
Many alien machines filled.
Mm-hmm.
It appears to be an abstract piece of alien art.
Really?
It appears to be an It looks like a control panel with slide switches.
Ooh, we got puzzles coming?
Many alien machines.
Yeah, yeah.
This appears to control some unusual security equipment. Many alien machines filled. Many alien machines.
Right.
This floor contains conduits for conducting geothermal energy.
Ooh, they're tapping into the planet for their energy?
James T. Kirk, captain of the Enterprise.
Correct.
Dr. McCoy looks back.
You don't want to go in here, McCoy?
Ensign Everts is looking around. Spock is analyzing the alien machines.
Not yet, he isn't.
I think we've found the answer to our mystery.
I wonder who or what constructed all this.
Logically, the machinery is sustaining some type of life in suspended animation. If we can reactivate the machines, then we may be able to meet its creators.
Its creators?
I'm just a security officer, sir.
I'm well aware of that, Ensign Everts. The time may come where you have to make the ultimate sacrifice for your team. Spock, I think it's time for you to analyze some of this crap.
fascinating, Captain. It is a diagram of a lunar eclipse of this planet. See how the red sphere, the moon, is casting a shadow on the blue sphere, Pollux 5.
Or a ball.
This must be a very old piece of work, because this planet's moon was destroyed thousands of years ago. The machinery is waiting for the gravitational pull of another eclipse to activate it. An eclipse that will never come. And one other thing, Captain. This may also be a diagram showing the proper settings on that control panel.
Pretty cool, Spock. You're awesome, Spock.
This control panel is a manual override for the alien life support equipment.
Manual override for life support equipment.
This alien construction takes readings of mental activity. It also activates manufacturing equipment related to security and includes a short-distance transportation device. It is an alien life support system, Captain, utilizing geothermal energy. It is still functioning, waiting for some sort of signal.
I suppose here it'll be the same.
It is an alien life support. It is an alien life support. It is an alien life support.
Okay. Do we interact with this stuff?
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain.
Well, how do we actually interact with this stuff? Put the hand here?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. Well, maybe I just have to walk over to it, and we can interact with this. Well, let's see what's in the other room as well. Can I? Apparently not. I don't see a wall, but I'm not able to go past. Are the arrow keys? No, the arrow keys move the cursor, so. Alright. What would McCoy have to say? I mean, there is life support equipment. He might know something about it.
You should ask Spock, Jim. This is a very old and very complex life support system. It appears to still be operational.
What do I do with this stuff? I would like to move this stuff around. I don't know how.
Nothing to report, Captain.
Destroy it? I mean, it's here. It's not being used for anything.
Don't you remember the Prime Directive, Captain?
Well, this isn't their equipment.
That action would be completely illogical, Captain.
Nah. So I guess I can't really interact with this stuff. I was trying to put the hand there and stuff, and maybe I can get. Did I try to get this?
You fail to obtain anything.
I fail to obtain anything. Alright. Well, other than just leave and report my findings, I'm not sure what to do. Talk to it?
You get no response. You get no response. You get no response. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Alright. Gonna leave. Then. I don't know how you interact with this stuff. Hold on a second. Go over here, Jim. I know, I'm being awfully familiar with you.
You fail to obtain anything.
I don't want to take anything. I want to, you know, interact with the equipment here. Alright, I guess we're leaving. We can't shoot it. I don't know how to interact with it unless there's some other way that I'm just not aware of. We'll report our findings back then. If I can... How the hell do I leave here? Can I leave here? Here we go. Okay, he's left. And back. We'll talk to these guys. Talk to these guys, too.
Does your tricorder say the cave is warmer, Spock?
It is not logical for me to use my tricorder to determine the cave's temperature, Doctor. I do not see what purpose it would serve.
Spock, everybody talks about the weather.
I'm sorry I let you down with those Klingons back there. I should have been paying more attention.
Just don't make that mistake again, Ensign.
Those Klingons give me the willies. They always have. My sister was wounded by them in the Chozon ambush.
We've all had our share of conflict with the Klingons, Ensign. The Organians told me that one day, humans and Klingons will become good friends. I wonder if I'll ever live to see that day.
Huh. I don't remember who the Organians are. Well, you should be lucky you're still alive, Kai. You're a red shirt.
Whoever was trying to stop us may not stop with those Klingons, Captain. I recommend extreme caution.
The thought had occurred to me, Mr. Spock, but thank you for mentioning it. The answer to this mystery lies ahead of us, gentlemen.
I never dreamed that Starfleet would be interested in my...
Oh my, okay, we can't say anything to anybody. What the hell are we supposed to do? Ooh. How'd I do that? We have to go into, I guess, inventory, but not select anything? Well, this is not very good controls here. So it's lit up halfway. Right? This is lit up halfway? I'm guessing. And this... Wait. How does that work? Huh. Middle?
Nothing happens.
Oh my god, I hate that voice.
Nothing happens.
Can I interact with this, too?
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.
Okay, that would be my answer. Well, we've got ourselves a bona fide puzzle here. Maybe the shadow going across really has nothing to do with all this.
Nothing happens.
I don't understand. Okay, I'm not sure what...
Ooh. Welcome to our home. Thank you for repairing our somnambutron.
Oh my.
Stop. You're trespassing on Federation territory.
Okay. I'm not completely sure why. Maybe because they're all lined up in one? I was just trying random crap, guys. Okay, so this is choice one.
I welcome you on behalf of the United Federation of Planets. Who are you? Where you come from?
I like that one better.
We did fix your machine. Can we write the repair bill off against rent on this land?
Oh my.
Stop. You're trespassing. We did fix. I welcome you on behalf of the United Federation of Planets. Who are you?
Going with it.
We call ourselves Nauians.
Nauians?
Thousands of years ago, we saw that meteor impacts were going to cause an ice age. We created this huge underground shelter to preserve our race, keeping us in suspended animation until the planet had recovered. Mm. We programmed the machinery to revive us at the next eclipse, but we did not count on the destruction of our moon.
Some advanced civilization.
Oh my.
Perhaps you can tell us about the demons. Some advanced civilization. Perhaps you can tell us about the demons.
Yeah, tell us about the demons.
The demons, as you call them, are created by a machine designed to keep intruders away from our sleep chambers. It pulls from the minds of any approaching creature their most feared enemy and produces replicas to scare them away. For you and your crew, it was Klingons. For the Tellarite, a wolf demon. And for the other humans, a demon from their religion. On behalf of my people, thank you for waking us. I will turn off the machinery which creates our guardians, so that they no longer bedevil those with whom we now share our home. Oh, woe! Alas! The key is missing. I can do nothing. Even we will suffer the attacks of our own guardians unless the key can be found. I implore you, if you can help, please do so.
Huh. Key, huh?
Have you found the key?
I think we found the answer to our mystery.
Perhaps we should try to communicate with the alien.
We already are.
Fascinating. This life form may represent what would have happened had the dinosaurs of your Earth not become extinct.
This is why I click on all of them.
What is that?
It's a Nauian. Weren't you paying attention?
The alien is humanoid with green reptilian skin. It appears unarmed.
Looks like it has arms to me.
James T. Kirk, Cap. Dr. McCoy looks back. Ensign Everts. The alien emerged from this metal chamber.
That he did.
This seems to be a cryogenic suspension chamber, Captain. This life form appears to be intelligent, a new sentient race. There appears to be a resemblance between it and the Silatus, although the present forms are quite small and definitely non-sentient. Nothing to report, Captain.
Why did you scan me?
This life form appears to be intelligent.
Oh, wait. Oh, whichever one you do, okay. Okay, you want a key, huh? We have this.
Nothing happens.
You don't want that. Okay, gotta find a key. Okay, I had to consult a walkthrough, unfortunately. Stumped me already. The general use key you use on this.
You are interested in my little museum of curiosities?
Looks like a pile of junk if you ask me. Yes, tell us about these things. Where did you find all this? Looks like a pile of junk of you. Where did you... Yes, tell us about these things.
Tell us about these things.
I enjoy talking about these treasures. Shall I go into mineral specimens? Meteorite. Fossil shells. Skull of a small alien animal. Twist of metal. Or would you rather move on to something else? Mineral specimens.
Yeah, let's hear about everything.
True curiosities, nothing more. I think they're very pretty, don't you? Shall I go into mineral specimens? Meteorite.
Meteorite.
I believe this is evidence of the cataclysm which destroyed the moon of Pollux 5 eons past. I've constructed a theoretical model based on analysis of the planet's rings of what things might have been like. I think that the moon, like Earth's moon, would have made a total eclipse of the sun possible. I would have liked to have seen that, for conditions making a perfect total eclipse are rare in the universe. Our God creates great wonders. Shall I go into mineral specimens?
Talking about that Bonnie Tyler song, aren't you?
Meteorite. Fossil shells.
See?
One of the oldest forms I've seen on this planet. Our God makes beautiful things indeed. Shall I go into mineral specimens? Meteor. Fossil shell. Skull of a small alien animal.
Yeah, that.
The skull of a modern Silati, the largest creature native to this planet. About the size of a house cat from Earth. The Silatis combine a rather insectoid pattern with four-legged reptilian form, including praying mantis-like forelimbs. Shall I go into mineral specimens?
That is Silati. I think that's what Spock said that the alien resembles. Obviously evolved from that animal.
Meteorite, fossil shell, skull of a small alien, twist of metal.
Twist of metal.
This chunk of rock is a greatly weathered example of a vanadium tungsten alloy, which doesn't occur naturally. It is my best evidence that the area was previously inhabited. Shall I go into mineral specimens? Meteor, fossil, skull, twist, or would you rather move on to something else?
Something else?
Very well. I can't imagine why, but if you have a further interest in any of this, take what you like. But please remember to return my treasures when you're done with them.
I can take stuffs.
You are interested in my little museum of curiosities?
Looks like a pile of junk if you ask me.
Oh.
Yes, tell us about these things.
I want to quit out of this.
I enjoy talking. Shall I go into mineral specimens? Or would you very well...
Alright, he says we can take stuff. Took that, and that, and that, and that, and that. Can I analyze this stuff even though it's in? No. If there is, I don't know how.
Sample of a local life form called a Silati, the largest animal reported on this planet. About the size of an Earth house cat, the Silatis have an insectoid reptilian genotype with praying mantis-like forelimbs.
I think I was using the phaser on it, guys.
A manufactured vanadium tungsten alloy of considerable age and indeterminate use.
Hmm.
A variety of rock specimens, including native silver, azurite, crystalline forms of various minerals. A completely ordinary nickel-iron meteorite.
Now, the stuff's all still here, interestingly enough.
Fossil shells in limestone substrate, compatible with local geologic features.
Now, what if I look at stuff like this? No. It switches to it. Oh. Okay. Can't even look at the hand anymore. Let's see if any of these things are what this creature needs.
Jim, think about that skull we picked up from Brother Stephen. Now look at this alien. See the resemblance?
Yes, I do. Anything new to say, besides that?
Perhaps we should try to commute.
Fascinating. This life form...
Right, okay. I am going to save.
Save new game.
Just in case it doesn't like what we're giving it and decides to pull out a blaster out of its butt and kills us. We'll save in the save for a while, so there's that. What would you like? You want this?
A child? No, I see many differences. This must be what our people who did not slumber have become. Still, I would like to see these remains properly interred, according to the precepts of our religion. May I keep this?
Of course. I think you will get along well with the Pollux inhabitants, and I'm sure you will have interesting theological discussions.
Maybe, if they aren't overbearing on you.
I think I should return it to where I got it from. No, I want to keep it as a memento for myself. I think I should return it to where I got it from.
Yeah. Let's not give people's property to somebody else. I feel that would be a bad idea. How about this shell?
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
You found the key.
Oh, good.
I can now turn off the machinery creating our guardians, and no more sentience shall be at risk.
Splendid.
Surely the Holy One smiles upon us all. I have no way to thank you, Captain. But please carry this request from my people to yours. We have much ancient knowledge we can share, and we would like to join your Federation. Go in peace.
I will be glad to accept your application to the Federation. We shall have a diplomatic envoy sent to make the final arrangements.
We look forward to meeting them.
Excellent.
We also look forward to having discourse with the colonists. Farewell. May the Holy One bless you.
Live long and prosper.
And also with you.
Kirk to Enterprise. Beam us up, Mr. Scott.
Nice effect.
Message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have read your report on the problems at Pollux 5 and evaluate your performance at 97%.
Wow.
You and your crew received 3 commendation points.
Nice.
The top brass at Starfleet are impressed. Outstanding work, Jim.
I might have known there weren't any demons.
We all have demons of our own, Bones. The ones we can't confront are often the hardest to deal with.
These demons were based on fear, Captain. A human failing.
I don't know, Spock. Everything that I've ever read about demons describes them as having pointed ears.
And away we go.
Hijack.
Hijack next episode. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one.